Hey, Azure Stack fans, I'm Mike Lamia from Dell Technologies, and today I want to demonstrate new configuration compliance visibility features for Azure Stack HCI. You know, even though I've lived in a geography prone to harsh winter weather all my life, I'm still not a fan of driving in snowstorms. Come to think of it, I don't like driving at night either. But it's the combination of the two, driving in the snow at night, that I hate the most. It's the lack of visibility that makes driving in the winter terrifying to me. But you know what's even more terrifying? Lack of visibility into my IT infrastructure's configuration compliance status. Configuration drift can be a huge liability for organizations. Changes to prescribed hardware or operating system attributes in production can leave businesses vulnerable to cyber attacks, performance degradation, data loss, and downtime. Governance services that can promptly detect and remediate deviations from the infrastructure's known good state is essential for survival. Now let's think about this in the context of Dell Integrated System for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI, which simplifies running Azure services on premises using software-driven automation that ensures a predictable operational experience. Our engineering organization rigorously tests and validates hardware, operating system, and cluster level property settings for inclusion into our deployment guide. Some of these recommended settings are configured during factory pre-installation of the Azure Stack HCI OS, and others are applied during initial deployment on-prem. How do you detect and remediate non-compliant configuration settings on your finely tuned integrated systems while running in production? Fortunately, Dell Technologies has developed OpenManage Integrations that fully automate lifecycle management and governance tasks. We've packaged up all our validated configuration settings into a single Dell HCI Configuration Profile policy definition. Plus, we provide a consistent hybrid management experience, meaning you can choose the control plane that best suits your requirements to monitor Azure Stack HCI compliance status against the Dell HCP baseline. For those of you with fleets of integrated systems spanning multiple data center and edge locations, you can manage either at scale through the Azure portal using Azure Arc, or locally on-premises using Windows Admin Center. Now let me show you what this looks like in action. First, notice that I have two Dell integrated systems for Azure Stack HCI registered with my Azure subscription. They've already been onboarded to Azure Arc-enabled servers, so I can view the collective health of their cluster nodes, VMs, and storage using Azure Stack HCI Insights in Azure Monitor. Now, this is a massive time saver for monitoring fleets of Azure Stack HCI systems at scale. Now I'll navigate to Azure Policy, and Azure Policy is used to enforce organizational standards and assess compliance. It's an indispensable tool for governance at scale. Here you can see some of the built-in Azure Policy definitions available in the Azure portal. Now to onboard the Dell HCP policy definitions for that consistent hybrid management experience, I'll browse to Windows Admin Center on premises, and specifically to the Dell OpenManage Integration extension. Now I'll click on the Azure tab. I'm signed into Azure automatically at this point because I previously registered Windows Admin Center with Azure. if Windows Admin Center was not registered, I would have been presented with a sign-in button here. And then I would have been prompted to enter my Azure credentials, fortunately, without having to leave this workflow. Step two is also completely automated. If I click on Show Details, I'll see that this step confirms that my integrated system is onboarded to Azure Arc and that I have the correct permissions to create and manage policies in my subscription. If these prerequisites were not met, I would have been provided specific instructions for meeting them. So now it's time to configure cluster settings. Here, I need to select the networking topology and deployment model I used when building this cluster. The specific Dell HCP policy definitions that get created in Azure Policy depend on the way the cluster is configured. I can hover over these tooltips to see more about these options. On this cluster, I leveraged a fully converged network topology with a scalable deployment model. Now I'll go ahead and click on Save and wait a few seconds while the system is analyzed for the applicable policies. And then I'll click on Onboard Policies. First, notice that I'm going to onboard version 1.1 of these Dell HCP policies. When newer versions of the policies become available in the future, I'll be presented with a message indicating that there is a new version available. Then I'll just use the same workflow to get those updated. Now I can scroll down to view all the policies applicable to this specific integrated system. You'll notice that we group together similar policies. These groupings will become what are known as initiatives in Azure Policy. Now I'll click on Onboard and give this a few seconds to complete. I can verify the successful onboarding of all the policies by clicking View Details. I can also export a report that lists all these onboarded initiatives and policies, so I can provide this to my Azure administrators for change control documentation. Now, when I come back into the Azure Policies definition blade and filter on initiatives and Dell, I can now see the Dell HCP initiatives that have been created for the 7525 based system. I onboarded policies from my other Dell integrated system named ASH Cluster outside of this recording. Now, each system must be onboarded to Azure Policy separately. Notice how the number of policies contained in the hardware and OS configuration initiatives don't match. That's because the two integrated systems are configured differently. The policy definitions that get onboarded are curated for specific AX node models and cluster topologies. Now I'll click on the hardware configuration policy for the 7525 system. The policy names are in the reference ID column. These are the same policies we saw confirmed as onboarded in Windows Admin Center using the Dell OpenManage Integration on premises. Okay, time to check compliance status from Windows Admin Center. So I'll browse over there and I'll browse to the HCP compliance tab. I need to insert my cluster settings one more time. Remember, Admin Center is a stateless application and thus doesn't have our previous selections stored. I click Save. After clicking on the check compliance button, I'd normally have to wait about a minute, but I've sped this up in the recording. Here we can see the overall compliance state dashboard. Then I'll scroll down to the policy summary. I think the hardware and OS configuration policies are self-explanatory. I'll need to enable the Dell infrastructure lock policy at some point. Having this enabled will prevent unauthorized or inadvertent changes to my hardware settings. The hardware symmetry policy checks to make sure that all components in the AX nodes align with the support matrix requirements and best practices recommended by Dell and Microsoft. Right now, I'm going to address the non-compliant hardware configuration policy right away here. Looks like the sysprofile property is non-compliant. This is a system profile setting in the BIOS that should be set to performance optimized according to our engineering testing and validation. This can have a negative impact on the overall performance of Azure Stack HCI if not corrected. So I want to navigate back to the Azure portal and show you what this looks like in Azure Policy as well. I'll leave the definitions blade and go over to compliance. Next, I'll click on that hardware configuration initiative for the AX7525 integrated system. And then I'll go to the policies tab. I'll click on the non-compliant policy and then click on the details for one of the three cluster nodes to show the reason for non-compliance. I can see the same information that I saw in Windows Admin Center about sysprofile. Also, note that create remediation task is grayed out in the Azure portal. Fortunately, I can perform remediation on a single cluster at a time with our OpenManage integration with Windows Admin Center. So I'll go back over to Windows Admin Center and I'll close this window and scroll back up and click the Fix Compliance button. Notice that the partially compliant policies appear under manual fixes. In the case of the Dell hardware symmetry policy, this is because the fix requires an on-site technician to add, remove, or replace devices. The Dell infrastructure lock policy fix is identified as manual because enabling that feature is accomplished by navigating to the security tab of the OpenManage integration. However, changing the value of the sysprofile property back to performance optimized can be done automatically. Changing this BIOS setting requires a reboot of each node in the cluster, but fortunately, we make these changes using the cluster aware updating framework, so there's no impact to running workloads on this cluster during the process. I'll choose to apply and reboot now, but you can also apply at the next reboot or during a maintenance window. So I'll click on apply. And now I can monitor the progress of this effort by clicking on view details. I've significantly sped this up in the recording. Each node progresses through three phases: running pre-update script, restarting, and running post-update script. The pre-update confirms that all VMs are live migrated to another node before the settings change and reboot occurs. The post-update confirms that VMs have been live migrated back before moving on to the next node in the cluster. All right, so after that's complete, I'll run a recheck of the compliance status. And give that just a moment. And very nice. The hardware configuration policy is now showing compliant. Now I want to confirm that what I'm seeing, that I'm seeing a consistent result in the Azure portal. So I'll just go back to where I was in Azure Policy and refresh the browser. And as expected, I see 100% compliant on the sys profile attribute. I'll also just browse back over to the hardware configuration policy to make sure that all is now green. And of course, this compliance checking will now continue to occur automatically to provide me with the peace of mind knowing that my systems are running in a known good state. Now, at any point, I can come back to our OpenManage integration and click on Export Compliance Summary to get a report generated for auditing purposes. Well, I hope watching this video proved to be a valuable use of your time. To learn more about the Dell Integrated System for Microsoft Azure Stack HCI and the Dell OpenManage integration with Windows Admin Center with all of its great features and functionality, please visit our Info Hub site and main product page where you'll find a whole lot more videos, white papers, blogs, etc. Also, if you'd like to speak more with an account manager about what you've seen, we've provided a QR code with contact information here. Thank you very much for watching.